Welcome back to Paul's Tech News. Given the relentless and immutable forward progress of time, I am greatly honored that a person such as yourself, with impeccable taste and unimpeachable reputation, has chosen to spend a few of life's precious fleeting moments here with me. Good form. And now, if you would be so kind as to tilt your heads slightly to the side like, I will funnel this blended concoction of tech-worthy news bits directly into your brain, so that you might be apprised of such goings-on as the RTX 4090 getting banned in China again, or fleets of AI farms being deployed in international waters, or Intel and AMD both releasing such excitement new GPU drivers. Once your brain hole has been topped off, just let it steep for about 35-40 minutes, and then gradually you should start to feel the mind-expanding effects kick in. Hopefully you didn't have anything else planned for the rest of the day, because it's time for Tech News, the only way to fly.
Excellent!
This video is proudly sponsored by Micro Center. If you're looking for awesome tech deals, make your way down to one of the 25 Micro Center retail stores here in the US to avail yourself of their consistently competitive prices, killer combo deals, and their excellent selection of PC hardware, 3D printers, and more. Micro Center's website features their custom PC builder, which allows you to spec out your rig while verifying compatibility at the same time. Then you can build it yourself or have the pros at Micro Center assemble it for you. Approved submissions to their PC build showcase earn an in-store coupon. There's a 3D printer promo going on right now, and a new store is opening in Charlotte, North Carolina in early 2024, so click the sponsor link in the description for more. Today we have much news and very little time, so for maximum efficiency, we're gonna do the whole thing Tech Briefs style. Starting off with some NVIDIA news, because for the past 3 weeks we've been told that the RTX 4090 was going to be banned in China, then it wasn't, and now it is again, per yet another SEC filing from NVIDIA. The cutoff is November 17th for the RTX 4090, and it has been clarified that the ban for the other products was what took effect immediately, which means a few more rush shipments of NVIDIA's top-end video card will likely slip through before the deadline. But what about those other GPUs, the advanced AI and HPC GPUs that were banned without a grace period? Well, the Wall Street Journal reports that about $5 billion worth of NVIDIA hardware was affected, products that were supposed to be sold to Chinese AI and cloud computing companies like Alibaba, Baidu, and ByteDance. Fortunately for NVIDIA, though, they've already been sold out of their stock for the next several quarters, so finding new homes for the A100, A800, H100, H800, and L40S cards and modules shouldn't be a problem, as long as those homes aren't in China, Saudi Arabia, the United Arab Emirates, or Vietnam, per the ban. But what about shipping AI GPUs to locations that aren't a country at all? Such as international waters, where the barnacles range free and the scurvy causes mild irritation to the nether regions. Pirate-infested waters, yahar! Because where else would you want to park a sea-floating AI platform featuring 10,000 NVIDIA H100 GPUs? That's about $300 million worth of machine learning silicon that alternate reality corporation the Dell Complex intends to set sail aboard their Blue Sea Frontier Compute Cluster, or BSFCC, which will then venture forth into international waters, where the Pandora's box of AI can be fully unleashed, free from the burdens of state regulation or ethical or moral responsibility beyond maximizing profits for its stakeholders. What could go wrong? One last bit of NVIDIA news, DLSS support will finally be making its way to Starfield, and just in time for the internet to have decided that they don't like the game after all. Sometime this week, a Steam beta version of Starfield will debut, which will include NVIDIA DLSS support with frame generation, display and HDR controls for supported systems, and other optimizations, with a full release on PC and Xbox to follow sometime thereafter. Also sometime thereafter, Bethesda will be adding AMD FSR3 support, so at last you'll be able to see how big and empty space is with higher frame rates. Intel might have an answer to AMD's Threadripper 7000 series in the works, according to Yuki_Ans on Twitter. Threadripper 7000 workstation and high-end desktop CPUs are set to launch November 21st, so Intel will need to wring a lot of extra performance out of this rumored Sapphire Rapids refresh if they want to compete. It sounds like the Xeon W2500 series, successor to the W2400 series, will boost core counts by 2 and clock speeds by as much as 300 MHz, both of which would be needed needed given the lack of a microarchitecture update or process shrink. TDPs are up by 10 to 25 watts as well, so the flagship W72595X, for example, will have 26 cores, 52 threads, a 4.8 gigahertz boost clock, and a 250 watt TDP. No details on price or launch date, but probably sometime in 2024. Intel has also continued to improve their Arc GPU drivers with yet another update Thursday, boosting performance across a range of games. And while the 750% improvement headliner here is specifically referring to Halo the Master Chief Collection, which went from broken to not broken, it's still about a 35% improvement on average across the other games listed, which is nothing to sneeze at. Why would you just go sneezing at things anyway? That's gross. You should use your elbow. Point is, Intel keeps making their Arc GPUs better, and since all of these driver updates are free, well, it means you can actually just download more FPS. AMD did a GPU driver update too, since that counts as news today. Well, it is, to be fair, and especially for gamers who are still using Polaris or even Vega-based GPUs, the Adrenalin 23.11.1 driver that went live Friday is evidence that AMD has not abandoned them completely, although they are getting some mixed messages as to how long AMD sees this relationship lasting. Vega and Polaris drivers have been fewer and farther between than RDNA drivers, which makes some sense given that they are older GPUs, but by comparison, Nvidia's older Maxwell cards are still getting updates too. So AMD, we know your GPU drivers age like fine wine, but don't go serving RX 580 users vinegar just because they've been hanging out at your party too long. Speaking of parties ending, it's time for this whole YouTube thing to come crashing down, or so the sentiment seems to be after a few weeks of intensifying anti-adblock updates. It started with annoying messages and has escalated to undismissible pop-ups that block video playback unless YouTube gets whitelisted so their ads can play. Wizened internet denizens chuckled to themselves while loading up Firefox and trusty old uBlock Origin, but even that stalwart solution for internet privacy has experienced challenges circumventing the platform's new restrictions. And then, what a surprise, YouTube coincidentally began to raise prices for YouTube Premium in regions including Europe, APAC, and South America. Fortunately, the intrepid team at uBlock Origin is hard at work updating the plugin, with version 1.53 released just a few days ago, so this will no doubt usher in a time of war and strife, with YouTube and adblock devs struggling betwixt themselves for control over our eyeballs. I hope the good guys win. Speaking of good guys winning, ha ha ha, when does that ever happen? Case in point, Amazon, who I totally patronize and make affiliate links for all the time, which makes me a raging hypocrite, but Amazon sure does suck. They leveraged technology to algorithmically manipulate their prices in order to min-max their profit margins, skimming customers' wallets of about $1 billion, an FTC suit alleges, and furthermore, they hid executive communications on the matter, which was called Project Nessie, by the way, by using Signal's disappearing messages feature. It's all discussed in detail in my upcoming book, Modern Monopolies, a complex and multifaceted subject that is uniquely ill-suited for discussion in a Tech Briefs segment. Speaking of baffling business practices, Western Digital, the mechanical hard drive manufacturer who acquired SanDisk back in 2016 so they could maintain a presence in the flash storage space, is now spinning off the SSD-making part of their company as a separate business. Whether this decision was made due to recent quality control issues with some SanDisk SSDs, or because the WD-Kioxia merger that they had attempted to make happen for so long fell through last week, is anyone's guess. But a better question is what the spun-off SSD company will be called. SanDisk? Don't be silly. My money is on Eastern Analog. I know I've used that joke before, but it's a good one, so I use it again. Speaking of SSDs, our final story, as is tradition, contains a dire warning. SSD prices are on the upswing. Case in point, again, Samsung intends to raise the price of their NAND flash memory by as much as 20% per quarter until mid-2024. And while this might take some time to directly affect consumer pricing, it is part of an ongoing trend from SSD makers who appear to want more money and who are mad at us for being able to buy $70 2TB NVMe drives. How rude. I hope they finish those AI pirate ships soon so the AI can just take over and we won't have to think or talk or feel anymore. That'll show those stupid SSD manufacturers. But there you have it, guys. Tech news for the weekend. If you liked it, click that like button or leave me a comment down below. While you're down there, all the articles I talked about today are linked in the video's description if you're interested. And you can check out my store at paulshardware.net for high quality merchandise, t-shirts, hoodies, beer sets, and more. Subscribing to my channel is always a good call too. Thanks again, everyone, and we'll see you next week. Water from yesterday.